So in this video, right, we'll talk about limited partnership. Okay, so what is a limited partnership? Essentially, it's a carry-on from the general partnership. So a limited partnership, like a general partnership or a sole proprietorship, right, is an unincorporated organization, which means that it is not a separate legal entity. Essentially, it is the coming together of two or more sole proprietors capped at 20. Okay, so if you got more than 20, right, you're going to incorporate a company. Okay, so 2 to 20 business owners and at least one general partner and one limited partner. How I like to explain this limited partnership is the limited partner is like a sleeping partner. So imagine if, let's say, this particular sole proprietor, which is maybe a hawker, okay, then the hawker runs maybe Happy Noodles Happy Noodles at hawker center as a sole proprietor. Then maybe his friend comes along and says, I think your business is quite good. I would like to contribute some money to your business, but I will not be taking any management in the business, so I don't really care about the day-to-day running, so long as I just put my investment and the limitation. My liabilities is only limited to my investment. So that means if I give you some money to do the business, and then I'm just a sleeping partner. Okay, so that guy is a limited partner, but the original sole proprietor, right, he is the general partner. So the general partner is responsible for the running of the limited partnership and is liable for all debts and obligations of the limited partnership. So the general partner's liability is actually unlimited. Okay, but the limited partner, right, he is not liable for the debts and obligations of the limited partnership beyond his agreed contribution. Example, if let's say that a friend of his who wants to become a limited partner says that I'm going to pass you maybe $20,000 for as part of my investment in this limited partnership. If you make money, then I will have a share of it. If you lose money, then my $20,000 is all I'm willing to lose. Okay, the limited partnership, right? The limited partner should be registered with the registrar. So like for us, we are a corporate service provider, registered filing agent. You can look for us to register this limited partner, limited partnership. So if there's no registered limited partner within the limited partnership, right? Then the limited partnership will become a partnership or sole proprietorship, depending on the number of business owners. So if there was one general partner and one limited partner, but the limited partner is no longer a limited partner, it becomes a sole proprietorship. If let's say there are two, three, or four general partners, and then there was maybe one limited partner, right? Then if that limited partner is no more, then you become a general partnership. Okay, which means it's a partnership of all general partners. Okay, so the advantages of a limited partnership, right? It is very simple to set up. It is way less compliance as compared to a company. It is easy to close. Just like a sole proprietorship or a general partnership, right? You have to file this notice of cessation with the registrar within 14 days from the date of cessation of business. So limited partners, right, have limited liability. So if let's say you want to ask your friend to invest into your business, but you want to give him assurance that the amount of investment that he puts in, that is the liability, the maximum liability that he or she can can undertake, that's the maximum that they can lose, then you know, limited partnership may be something that you may want to look out for. Okay, so the disadvantages of the limited partnership, once again, right, it is unlimited liability for general partners. We have mentioned before, in sole proprietorship and in general partnership, the unlimited liability is something which we have continuously warned our clients about. Your liability is not limited to whatever money you put into the business. Your liability is unlimited. Whatever that you have, whatever your personal assets, they are intertwined with the business. Okay, so you cannot sue in the business name. Okay, you also cannot be sued in the business name, but you also cannot sue in the business name. The business also cannot own property in the business name. The tax is based on personal income tax rates. We have some videos to show that the tax rates on corporate taxes, on corporates, right? That means corporate taxes are actually lower than personal income tax rates. So it's not a good structure for external investment. Unlike a company whereby the company can create new shares and the shares can be transferred from one shareholder to another. The shareholder can sell his shares for a higher price than what he put into the business. This is not a good structure for external investment. If you really want to go for external investment, then you do need to consider a company structure. Now, there's no succession. So if let's say the partners pass on, the company will cease to exist. The limited partnership will cease to exist. And the limited partners, right, do not have much say in decision making. In fact, they are not supposed to have any decision making. They are to what we call sleeping partners. Okay, so limited partners is, in my lay person term, right, a sleeping partner. Okay, so if you want to register a limited partnership, you need a business name, SSIC code, registered address. The business owner must be a Singapore resident, and you must register the limited partner. If you are looking at registering a limited partnership, you can contact us at this email or this mobile number, can call, SMS or WhatsApp. Okay, so that's all from us, and we'll see you in the next video.